Alright, welcome back. So the goal for today is to talk about how we can rewrite double integrals over a given region R as an iterated integral. So that way we can use that technique that we introduced yesterday, that technique of partial integration, to actually calculate the net volume under the graph of a function of two variables, so that we didn't have to go through all this silly business of calculating volumes of rectangular solids. So we'll be doing that today with regions that are relatively straightforward. We're going to focus on regions R that are triangles and rectangles. So let's get started. So let me describe to you the general process here. And let's try and rewrite the double integral over the region R of a function f of xy as an iterated integral. And we're going to start with the case that we're going to rewrite the iterated integral in the order where y comes first and then x comes after y, the order dy dx. And I think it's sometimes informative to have a running example. So let's let R be a triangle which goes from 0, 0, let's mark that 0, 0, to 4, 0, and then up to 4, 2. So R is going to be a triangular region. Running example. Step number one, draw the region R. So sometimes it's given to you in pictorial form, but usually it's not given to you in pictorial form. And so your job is to draw the region R yourself. And so our region R is this triangle, which we've drawn over here to the side. Okay, identify the function y equals h of x, which bounds the region on the top, and the function y equals g of x, which bounds the region on the bottom. So let's go back to our drawing for this. The top of the region is bounded by this diagonal line, which I will indicate here in pink. It's a linear function which stretches from the point 0, 0 to the point 4, 2. So it's a line with a 0 y-intercept with a slope of 1/2, and so this function is y equals 1/2 x. So this function, indicated in pink, would be the one which bounds the region on the top. And then, here on the bottom of the region, it's just the flat line on the x-axis. So here, the region is bounded on the bottom by the function y equals 0. So I'll draw that in cyan. Okay, so for our function, we found that h of x, the function on the top, was 1/2 x. And g of x, the function on the bottom, was 0. All right. Step number three. Amongst all the points in the region, identify the smallest x-coordinate, call it A. Identify the largest x-coordinate, call it B. So let's go back to our drawing. This region stretches from, at its most extreme, this corner up to this line on the right. So the smallest x value that is present in this region is x equals 0, the x coordinates on the pointy far left side of the region. Smallest x, A equals 0. Largest x, B equals 4. All right. So then, now that we've identified A and B, and h of x and g of x, to form our iterated integral, all that we have to do is put those quantities into their appropriate positions in the general form of an iterated integral that has y coming first. So here would be our final answer. The double integral of r over r of f of x, y can be expressed as an iterated integral where a, the smallest x value, is 0, b, the largest x value, is 4. The function that bounds the region on the bottom is 0, and the function that bounds the region on the top is 1/2 x. This is what we would write if we were choosing an iterated integral that had y first and x last. Now remember from the end of last video that whenever we're setting up one of these iterated integrals, we should do a quality assurance check to make sure that we didn't write something that was nonsensical. So let's just make sure. Our outermost limits of integration are 0 and 4, those are just constants. And our inner limits of integration are 0 and 1/2 x, which are either constants or functions of the outer variable x. So this looks fantastic. All right. Now let's demonstrate for the same region what we would get if we were going to try to rewrite the function in the order where x came first and y came after that. So for educational purposes, let's take the same region as before. Okay, first things first, if you're going to let x be your inner limit of integration instead of y, as in the previous example, if x comes first, then what you want to do is you want to look at your region and identify the function x equals h of y, which bounds the function on the right. And you want to identify the function of y, which bounds the region on the left. Okay. Now, some folks actually like to rotate their paper, to rotate, in my case, my tablet, so that right actually looks like it's pointing up. But if I rotate my screen, it's not like y'all are gonna see it. So here, I'm going to draw in the rightmost function. Rightmost. Which is the constant function x is always equal to 4. And then on the left-hand side, the left border of this triangle is always given by this slanted diagonal line. So here is the left function, which we found earlier was y equals 1/2 x, but this time we need x as a function of y. So let's rewrite this as x equals 2y. All right, we've found the function which bounds our region on the right. The function which bounds our region on the right was x equals h of y has to be 4 for the right region. And then we found the function which bounds our region on the left. That was the line g of y equals 2 times y, the pink slanted line on the left. All right, so now that we've identified the function on the right and the function on the left, our goal is to identify amongst all the points in the region who has the smallest y coordinate and who has the largest y coordinate. Okay. So, looking at all the points in this region, the largest y-coordinate is located at the tip-top of this region, and it has a y-coordinate of 2. Meanwhile, the lowest y-coordinates in this region are located at the bottom of the region, where the y-coordinate is 0. So, smallest y-coordinate is C equals 0. The largest y-coordinate is D equals 2. And so, what double integral will we set up based on this analysis? At this point, we just need to fill in the blanks of this general format. The inner limits of integration will be the two functions of y that we found, and the outer limits of integration will be the two values of those two values of y that we found. So my final answer for this running example would be that the double integral over this region R of any function f of x could be expressed as the iterated integral y going from 0 to 2, x going from the lowest x to y to the highest x 4 f of x, y, with the order of integration dx dy. Now let's check one more time. The outer limits of integration are just constants. The inner limits of integration are either constants or functions of the outer variable y. So, depending on the order of integration that you decide to use, y first versus x first, you're going to get very different looking limits of integration. In the case that we chose x to be first, we had the limits from 0 to 2 followed by 2y to 4. But for the exact same region, if we chose y to be first, then we had the limits from 0 to 4 and from 0 to 1/2x. Now the process that we're doing here is fundamentally pretty similar to back in Calculus 1 when you were doing method of washers and method of shells to find the volumes of solids of revolution. There was usually a process involved where you had to find these functions which bounded your region either top, bottom, or right and left. And we're back to doing that here, except for a different purpose. But the ideas are the same.